11. Romans chapter 13 verse 11. The Bible reads, and I quote, "And that, knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep." Slap your neighbor, say, "Wake up." If your neighbor don't communicate, change neighbor. Some neighbor are destiny killers in church. A talkless neighbor around you pushes away blessing to you. People that don't talk around you, they push blessings from you. Under the anointing, talking is pivotal to what you receive.
Yes, sir.
Tell your neighbor, wake up.
Wake up.
Romans 13:11 says, "And that, knowing the time, that now it is high time to wake out of sleep."
Yes, sir.
"For now is our salvation nearer." I thought someone shout amen.
Amen.
"Now is our salvation nearer than when we believed."
Yes, sir.
Father, I thank you for the reading of the word. Let this word put on flesh in our lives. Turn situations around.
Amen.
Birth a new destiny.
Amen.
Birth a new identity.
Amen.
And make us kingdom established entities in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please, I want you to joyfully sit down in the presence of God as kings and as queens. Grab your Bibles, your notepad, but most importantly, make sure your faith pad is activated, because your faith is your launch pad into the realms of all possibilities. Everyone on Apostolic TV, God bless you, and thank you for joining us tonight. For those who are watching virtually from any part of the world, God bless you. And those who are here, God bless you. I bring you a word charge, meaning a message titled "Preparation for Successful Living." Preparation for successful living. Preparation for successful living. I started part one on Thursday. Today is part two. Preparation for successful living, under the theme "Power of Preparation," part two. The Bible says in Romans chapter 13, verse 11, "And that, knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep, for now is our salvation nearer than when we believe." I said on Thursday, a man that fails to prepare, prepares to fail. If you hate preparation, you better write off celebration. If you hate preparation, you better write off your access to prosperity. Great men don't live without preparation. Preparation help you detail your agenda, the agenda of your existence. It says, "For now we know," in Romans 13 verse 11, "the time." But you see, there is something in Romans 13 11 that breaks my heart. It says, "For now is our salvation nearer than when we believed." Meaning there are situations some people have found themselves, they've given up on salvation. You think God has forgotten you, and there is no possibility out of that situation. You look behind you, you see the Egyptians with their chariots and their drawn sword. You look ahead of you, you see the Red Sea, and it looks like there is no way forward. Suddenly you lose hope. No more belief in you concerning that matter. But the Lord has sent me to tell someone,
yes, sir,
that your salvation is nearer than when you first believed.
Amen.
I don't think you heard me. Your salvation is closer than when you first believed.
Amen.
I say your miracle is nearer than when you first believed.
Amen.
Your testimony is closer than when you first believed.
Amen.
The Bible says weeping may endure for a night.
Yes, sir.
But joy comes in the morning.
Yes, sir.
I don't care how long you have wept. I don't care how long you have sorrowed.
Yes,
I don't care how long you have waited.
Come on.
I don't care if your waiting season has, has outlasted your hope in believing, I prophesy.
Prophesy.
I become your prophet and I fly for you.
Hey,
I decree you are leaving the place of waiting hopelessly to a place of receiving bountifully.
Amen.
I don't think you are hearing me. I don't think you are hearing me. I don't think you are hearing me. I say you are leaving the place of waiting hopelessly to a place of receiving bountifully.
Yes, sir.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please be seated. And that knowing the time, and now is that time to awake out of sleep. For now is our salvation nearer than when we believed. Do you still see the light at the end of the tunnel? Or you don't see any way out of the tunnel? You can be so deep in trouble, you don't believe in prayer anymore. You can be so deep in the pit of financial obscurity and you don't see security anymore. Child of God, before you get to the place where you become heirs of salvation, preparation is pivotal. How prepared are you for your day of visitation? Because your date with destiny never tells you. The day God plans to visit you, he won't tell you. There are those who will fast and pray, cry to God, seek his face. But the moment their helper locates them and the helper asks them, what do you want God or what do you want me to do for you? They go speechless. Meaning no preparation. No preparation. Some come into the house of God without mentally, spiritually, psychologically preparing themselves to receive. In the house of God and in the presence of God, blessings are dropped. And it is only them with a violently prepared faith that takes home. In the realms of the spirit, selfishness is permitted. I don't know who I'm talking to. Am I talking to you? Let me face two of you. In the realms of the spirit, greed to collect is permitted. From the days of John the Baptist up until now, the kingdom of God suffers violence only. Is there only here tonight? Yeah. I'm looking for that only sister.
Hey.
I'm looking for that only brother.
Yes, sir.
I'm looking for that only man.
Yes, sir.
I'm looking for that only auntie.
Yes, sir.
I'm looking for that only grandmother.
Yes, sir.
I prophesy.
Prophesy.
Whatever God has planned for you, you are taking it home.
Amen.
The blessings that the enemy has stolen from you. Your virtue has been violated.
Yes, sir.
Your time has been violated.
Yes, sir.
Tonight it is restored and receive compensation in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Only the violent takes.
Yes, sir.
When it comes to spiritual matters, my sister, you have to be violent and selfish.
That's true, sir.
If you are not violent in the place of prayer and you allocate. That moment with people or to people, your blessings will relocate to them. Blessings will relocate. Many don't prepare. Please sit down. God bless you. Many don't prepare. How prepared are you? See, coming to church is not by the suit you wear. You can be suited physically but naked spiritually.
Kabash.
You can be clothed physically but your faith is naked. But when you cover your faith with preparation, meaning I am going into the house of the God.
Yes,
the
sir.
Bible says in the presence of God is fullness of joy. And at the right hand are pleasure.
Yes,
forevermore. For you to receive pleasure from God, you must be prepared mentally.
Yes,
you
sir.
Must be suited and put this faithfully.
Yes, sir.
You must be ready to receive violently. Abalagadash. And your pressure gives way for pleasure. Can I pray for someone with pressure here?
Pray, sir.
What is putting pressure on you? Is it financial pressure?
Hey.
Is it health issues? Is it marital pressure?
I
prophesy the pleasure that is in the house of God, the pleasure that is by the right hand of Jehovah. Receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
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 I want you to jump, run left, run
hey.
Right.
Hey.
I want you to holler my time.
Hey. My time is here.
My time.
My time is here. Hey.
Please be seated. To be victorious in living, you must be a well-prepared man. The Bible says, in Proverbs 21, verse 31, the horse is prepared against the day of battle. Child of God, you don't take a donkey to war. You will die a monkey. You don't take a donkey to war. Donkeys are not made for war. You need horses with horsepower. The horse is prepared for the day of battle. The safety is of the Lord. Stop asking God for safety if your horse is not ready. Am I communicating here?
Yes, sir.
Pastor Brennan, sir. Don't ask God for safety if your horse for battle is not ready. Father, fight for me, fight for me, fight for me. He's looking at me. He said, what have you given me to use to fight for you? Do you know that we empower God to fight for us? One way to empower God to fight for you is not only prayer, it is praise. Praise is, your praise is Jehovah's weapon to fight for you.
Yes, sir.
Go and ask Joshua in Joshua chapter 6. The walls of Jericho did not experience an armor or a chisel. It was praise that brought down the walls.
Yes, sir.
Praise was Jehovah's weapon to bring down a strong wall. Am I communicating here?
Yes, sir.
Many don't prepare. You want victory in life, but you've not mounted your horse to battle. The way you ride a horse going to a picnic in the garden is different from how you ride a horse going into war. The weapons of your warfare, they are not kind of brother.
No, yes, sir.
They are mighty through God to pull. Someone say pull. Habalabalagadash. To pull down stronghold. We wrestle not against flesh and blood. Your wrestling is not with Uncle Ike.
Rara, sir.
Your wrestling is not with Shango or Hare Krishna. What is that man's name? Ishawuru. Arometa is too small. They are, you know, human beings, they are not the ones we fight.
Yes, sir.
Just as the Spirit of God possesses us, so the devil possesses some people to fight. So to fight and be victoriously preserved in life, you must be well prepared for battle. Knowing preparation helps you know your enemy well. Preparation helps you know your enemy.
That's right, sir.
The Roman empires, they were always prepared. Even sleeping, they are prepared to kill. Roman soldiers in those days, whilst they were sleeping, whilst asleep, they're still prepared to kill. They don't sleep without their sword. Many believers sleep without their sword. Hence the reason why the enemy comes when you are sleeping and butchers you. If you faint in the day of trouble, child of God, the Bible says your strength is weaker.
Yes,
don't sleep and don't go to bed without your sword.
Yes,
what
sir.
Is your sword? The word of God.
Yes,
the
sir.
Bible says the word of God is fast, it is quick, and it is powerful.
Hey.
There is something about the word of God. You see, it's sharper than any two-edged
sword.
Don't sleep without the word, child
yes,
of God.
Sir.
Don't go down without the word.
Hey.
That is what the Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 13 verse 11. It says, wake up, wake up, wake up.
Yes,
because
sir.
The time of salvation, your time of victory, your time of help, your time of turnaround
hey.
Is no longer as far.
Yes,
it's
sir.
No longer far.
Yes,
it's no longer far.
Yes, sir.
It's no longer far.
Yes.
Your miracle
yes.
is no longer far.
Amen.
I don't know how long you have waited. I prophesy. Tonight, receive your miracle.
I receive
your breakthrough.
I receive.
Receive your deliverance.
I receive.
Receive your liberty.
I receive.
There is a God in heaven
yes.
who has sent me to tell you
yes, sir.
That whoever has said you will not make
speak,
it.
Speak, sir.
Whatever is opposing God's plan against your life, opposing God's plan for your
yes,
life,
sir.
Tonight let the power of God locate and destroy.
Amen.
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 Lift your right hand, shall power.
Wow.
Please be seated. Are they not all ministering spirits? Hebrews chapter 1 verse 14. Sent forth to minister to them or minister for them who shall be heirs of salvation. To be heirs of salvation means to engage and become successful, liberated. Salvation means deliverance. To be heirs of salvation is to be an inherit, to inherit God's agenda for your life. Many are living below the standard God has set for your existence. God designed you to be the chief cornerstone. You are living as some backroom stone. See, listen. If you look at Hebrews 1:11, there is a key word there. Are they not all ministry spirits? Hebrews 1:11. Sent forth to minister. What is the word there? It says to minister for. To minister for them that shall. To minister for. Every time we wake up, there is always a ministering spirit sent out to minister for us. You are going through a situation, there is a ministering spirit sent out to minister for you. Stop taking up carnal weapon to fight a satanic deity. There is a ministering spirit sent out to minister for you. There are battles we are fighting ourselves. When God has sent out a warrior,
yes, sir,
an archangel to fight for you,
yes, sir,
it's time to drop your AK-47,
hey,
and pick up a word that is sharper than any two-edged sword.
That's right,
it's
sir.
Time to stop speaking grammar and engage power,
yes, sir,
and watch your life turn around.
Yes, sir.
Listen, I speak with audacity tonight. I speak with authority.
Speak,
that whatever
sir.
Has decided to make you a non-entity,
in the name of
that
Jesus.
Power scattered by fire.
Amen.
That power scattered by fire.
Amen.
That power scattered by fire.
Amen.
That power scattered by fire.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lay your hands on his hands. Scatter.
Scatter.
Sit down, please. Are they not all ministry spirits? A man who fails to prepare prepares to fail.
That's right, sir.
Preparation makes you a candidate for celebration. To face your Goliath in life, you must go into battle alert. To kill your Goliath, you must go alert. Many are sleeping and you want to fight an enemy that is always awake. I don't know who I'm talking to. Many are sleeping. Many believers are part-time prayer warriors, but you want to fight a full-time enemy. Part-time ministry is different from full-time ministry. You can't be a part-time minister and engage full-time power for ministry. Am I saying something? You can't be a part-time minister and engage full-time power for ministry. You can't be a part-time prayer warrior and engage full-time fire against the devil. Am I communicating here?
Yes, sir.
You can't be part-time on your knees before God and want to stand full-time on your feet above devils. They say practice makes what?
Perfect.
Oh, come on now. Practice makes perfect.
Yes, sir.
Whatever you practice regularly.
Yes, sir.
Whatever becomes a lifestyle.
Yes, sir.
Whatever becomes a pattern of life.
Yes.
Automatically, it yields a particular type of evidence.
Yes, sir.
You can't be on your feet when you want to pray, when you choose to pray, and then you expect God to always show up.
Hey.
Child of God, remember the enemy is on a threefold assignment.
That's right.
To kill, to steal,
and to destroy.
Child of God, you must understand that the Bible says in Revelation chapter 12, verse 12,
speak to me,
the
sir.
Enemy came to the earth with great wrath.
Yes, sir.
But the most important word in Revelation chapter 12, verse 12, is that the enemy knows that he has but a short time.
Yes, sir.
The enemy has a short time.
Yes, sir.
So when the enemy wants to destroy a man, the enemy moves with speed and the enemy does it on a full-time basis,
yes, sir,
to ridicule the man. You cannot be a part-time Christian and defeat a full-time devil.
At all.
You cannot be a part-time Christian and bury a full-time enemy.
At all.
I want to pray for someone today.
Pray for
the
me,
grace
sir.
To be a full-time prayer
hey,
warrior receiving.
How about that? Yeah, I receive.
Receive that grace.
I receive.
Receive that grace.
I receive.
Receive the mantle of prayer.
I receive.
Receive the mantle of prayer.
I receive.
Receive the mantle of prayer.
I receive.
The appetite to pray.
The
appetite to pray. The appetite to pray. There are many people, when they get on their knees to pray, when they get on their knees to pray, all you see them do, after 30 seconds, they snore on their knees. The Bible says, wake up. Awake, awake out of your sleep. Slap your neighbor, slap your neighbor. Say, open your eye. Open your eyes and pray. Open your eyes and pray.
Open your eyes
stop
and pray.
Stop sleeping too much.
Stop sleeping
stop
too
sleeping
much.
Too much.
Stop sleeping
open
too
your
much.
Eyes and pray.
Open your eyes and
the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 6, it says, go to the ants. Go to the ants, all ye sluggard.
Hey.
If you are a sluggard, you will never live life on guard.
Hey.
If you are a sluggard, you cannot live life on guard. If ants don't sleep, you human being, full grown man, you are sleeping, you want to die. Some people sleep like they're inviting death.
Hey.
Don't you know that sleep is the cousin of death?
Wow.
Sleep is the cousin of death.
Yes, sir.
Am I communicating
with you? Yes, sir.
Sleep is the cousin of death. Listen, I would rather be overprepared than underprepared.
Try.
In the book of Matthew chapter 25, the Bible says the kingdom of God is likened to 10 virgins. These 10 virgins were given 10 lamps. And these 10 lamps, the Bible says, 5 oiled their lamps and 5 did not. I use the word, I say, Father, what does lamp mean? The Bible says, believers who are empowered with the word, but don't oil their lives with the word. The Bible says in Psalm 119 verse 105, thy word, O Lord, is a lamp. The word of God is your lamp.
Yes, sir.
If you are walking in darkness, it means the word of God in you is weak. I don't know who I'm talking to here. Matthew 25. 10 virgins. 10 virgins. They were given the same type of lamp. You see some people move in a different dimension of God's power. Child of God, God, please, sit down. I want to say something to you all tonight. God does not love anybody more than another person. Please, listen to me. Pastor B, the Lord does not love you more than me, is a lie. Neither does the Lord love me more than you. The Lord does not love you more than her. If you think so, you are cheating yourself. The Lord does not love Apostle more than you, Waters. No, sir. Tell them what go on. He loves all of us. Eh? Say it in Jamaican accent.
Yeah, the all of us same way.
All of us the same way. Lift your legs up, power!
Hey, power! Kabash!
The Lord loves us the same way.
Hey.
But what differentiates us is the level of grace we choose to press into.
Yes, sir.
The level of grace we choose to press into. And how do you press deeper into grace is by the value of the word you carry. See this, the power output a man releases is by the knowledge of the word he carries. Oh, I'm losing you. It's true. Eh? The power output a man releases is by the capacity of the word he carries. To be a city, you need capacity. Dubai. Build with capacity. Nigeria build without. Nigerian government don't have capacity. Huh? That is why a country like Nigeria that has all the resources more than Dubai, you still see them going to buy houses in Dubai. Hey, I just bought a house in Dubai. You are celebrating backwardness.
Chai.
Do you know in those days we used to feed Dubai? Nigeria used to feed Dubai. There was a time where we bring Naira to Heathrow Airport. People queued at Heathrow Airport to buy Nigerian money. In the 70s and early 80s, my mother would arrive at Heathrow Airport. They used to buy a Naira. But now, we celebrate 10 pounds. We are celebrating the Queen head when we have Jehovah's head.
Come on. Hey.
Your capacity determines your audacity.
Yes, sir.
No capacity, you will be a non-entity. Anybody can beat you, talk to you anyhow. Are you understanding me? 10 virgins. 10 of them. Listen, you have no excuse in life to fail. You cannot fail. If you fail, it's your fault. It's not our fault. It's not the food she cooked for you. Look at your stomach, Richard.
Hey.
Excellent is your name. What a wonderful life.
Hey, excellent is your power.
See this instrumental is going to put you in trouble. Listen to me. Please, I want to say, and see, number one, I said God does not love anybody more than anyone else. Number two, God does not give anyone advantage over anyone else. When starting the race of life, the advantage that God gives us is equal. But what makes others run better than others in life, what makes others fly faster than others in life,
yes, sir,
is by the reason of your ability to prepare.
Yes, sir.
Sometimes someone is in the gym, you are fasting, you are praying, you are running, you are building capacity, whilst your neighbor is at home eating fufu, eating special fried rice, jerk chicken and rice and peas. You are eating and eating and eating. Do you want to turn to a kitchen? You eat so much, turn to a food warehouse. And you then want to compare yourself with someone who is fasting and praying and gyming. Look, I'll do something tonight. Now watch this. I used to play football before. By the grace of God, I played to a certain level that I know, even though I wanted to be a complete professional, the Lord had a different career for me. You know, the Lord said, no, don't be a player. Come and play for me. Now watch this. No matter how skillful I am in the head, right now, if you tell me to run 200 meters, after 50 meters, I will stop. I'll say, you want to kill me. I don't have stamina. You have to have stamina for such. Sergio Makufo, sir. Let me do an example. You see him there. He has played football. He can set his name online. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, of
course. He has played far. Eh? Right now, he's so fit. Him. His fitness is more than physical studies. Imagine, see, no matter how skillful. Now watch this. He's a left-footed player, right? You're a winger. What was my position? I'm a winger, left-footed player. No matter how skilled, if my leg is as sharp as a razor blade, I shoot ball like Beckham. Forget that shooting. If I shoot it anyhow, muscle pull will hook me. Muscle pull will grab my leg. Why? The lap is no longer muscled enough in training. I don't have capacity to last more than 5 minutes.
Yes, sir.
I went to play football. Now, hear me.
Jesus.
Catherine Town invited me to just come and train with them. What day was that? I should have respected myself and said no.
Very quickly.
But I said, I have skill. I said, I am a baller.
Show them.
What you think you are is different from what you practice to be.
Hey.
What you think you are is different from what you exercise yourself to become.
Yes, sir.
Many carry ability to sing, but you don't go for vocal training. Child of God, you will sing like a frog.
Hey. Tell them, sir.
You will sing like a frog. Oh. You can be with me, you're still in your head, but when you sing, you will be like a frog. Mm. You know, how many of you have imagined yourself having a very lovely voice? Mm-hmm. But the moment you just sing, everyone say, please, please, please. Hey, 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 hey.
The blood of Jesus.
They bind you like the devil. I went to play football. As soon as I, after 5 minutes, this is my left leg. There was something moving. It's called hamstring.
Thank you, Jesus.
I went from 30 kilometers per hour to 15. I reduced the speed. So, listen, I started respecting myself. The boy in the middle threw one very, very beautiful through pass. Those that know football understand what I mean by through pass. Through pass is when you are given a nice pass that beats the defenders for you to then go score a goal.
A one triangle.
Look at me. When I saw the curve on the ball, I ran, I overtook the first defender. That was my mistake. As soon as I took past the first defender from the right wing, because I was coming from the left, I didn't know that the two center defenders, they told themselves, let us, we will show him that we that trained, we're not foolish for training. Mm-hmm. You can't just come here and insult us with your 5 minute skill.
There are
people who see you standing today.
Yes, sir.
They don't know what you have been through in life.
Hey.
For you to build the capacity you have.
Yes,
to
sir.
Be in the position.
Yes.
They see you driving a Mercedes.
Hey.
They see you driving a BMW.
Yes, sir.
They don't know what you have had to go through.
Yes,
your
sir.
Days of walking.
Yes,
your
sir.
Days of trekking.
Yes,
your
sir.
Days of hunger.
Yes, sir.
All the picture is how you look good.
Hey.
And they think that your 15 years to be where you are, it will take them 15 seconds. It's a lie.
Error.
Look at me. I took the, when I went, I was feeling good. I saw through pass. The center defender was a 16-year-old boy.
Thank you.
But he's so tall. He's taller than them, Sino Waters.
Uh-huh.
And he's built.
Mm-hmm.
The kind of gym, I don't know if he eats a manure. It's like this guy eats fertilizer. He's so thick, 16-year-old defender. When I saw the through pass, look at the, see, I went, I maneuvered past the first guy, and I saw the ball. I saw the keeper coming. So in my head, what I wanted to do was, the ball had a little bounce. So what I wanted to do was pass through the, after beating the first defender, as soon as the ball got through the middle, the two central defenders, I was just going to go like that, chip it over the head of the, they wanted me to do it.
Uh-huh, my boys.
Uh-huh. As soon as I got there and I tried to raise one leg,
correct.
The boy, this 16-year-old boy just looked at me.
Mm-hmm.
He allowed me to get close to the ball. When he turned, he gave me full sweeping.
Correct guy.
He swept me. I say he took me, took the ball, took my destiny in football. He took my football destiny.
Hey.
When he cleared me, all I remembered was I was on the ground. I say, help me.
help me.
I remember Jesse was there with me. My son was there with me. I got up. I was limping. The two central defenders, that was when they laughed to themselves.
Well done, sir.
Then they carried on playing their football. You know what made it worse? My son, from off the pitch, imagine when you see professionals training. My son said, Dad, what are you doing there? Everyone is down there.
Correct.
I said, Son, you don't understand what hit me. I said, Son, you don't know the kind of train that jammed me here.
Hey.
What hit me? It is people who have prepared.
Uh-huh.
Don't be fooled by my small appearance.
Uh-huh.
There is a great God I have encountered in prayer.
Yes, sir.
So when I see the devil coming like a train,
hey,
he doesn't know that we know the place that can stop a
train. That's right, sir.
No matter how the enemy comes running, rushing like a flood,
yeah,
I have built capacity through God Almighty in me.
Yes.
So there's a standard.
Yes, sir.
Can I prophesy?
Prophesy.
I don't know how long you have waited for your miracle. I don't know how long you have waited for your testimony.
Yes, sir.
Listen, I want you to understand you're not forgotten.
Yes, sir.
God has been building capacity in you. Your time to arise has come.
Amen.
Your time to shine has come.
Amen.
Your time of laughter has come.
Amen.
Your time of victory has come.
Amen.
Your time of joy has come.
Amen.
I want you to jump down and say, my time has come.
My time has come. Oh. Yeah.
Please be seated. 5 minutes we pray. Why did I tell Sergeant Mokofo to stand up? Stand up. Look at the size. He looks very, very, He looked like Indomie.
Jesus.
But let him hit you. It's not size, though. It is what is inside the size.
Of course, sir. Mm-hmm. That's what we tell them.
Yes, play. Was it Gilly? You played for Gilly. Was it Gilliam? Yeah? Charlton and all of them. Oh, yeah, this one, they play football. They've chopped small. All this EPL money.
Mm-hmm.
I told him to stand up because look at the size. But the kind of regime, the training they do. You stand up, stand there.
My father. Error.
Stand here!
Error. Error.
Look at how thick he is. You see that he's spread. Put two of them on the pitch. Now watch it. What is he doing? He's doing this. He's doing this. He's, hey. You will understand that football is not hey. Watch this. In his mind, he is Diego Maradona.
Voila.
Listen to me. Let me bust your bubble in. See, that bubble. See, listen. What you think you are, you cannot become until you engage it. You prepare for it.
Yes, sir.
You cannot be a financial pillar in the house of God if your hand is like someone that is leprous.
Yes, sir.
To give to the poor, you don't give.
At all.
To give offering, you don't give.
At all.
All you want is want. Uh-huh. Want. What are you? Are you a wanting, blood-sucking demon?
Non-profit.
You've never given in your life. All you want is want. Are you a wanting machine?
Voila.
Look at how he spread. He spread like butter on bread.
Hey. Frying pan.
I'm finishing you. Stand there, my friend. He spread like butter on bread.
Hey, Jesus.
Look at him. He just looked there. He looked like one strand of spaghetti. But I'll finish Sergio Marco for today. But you see that one strand of spaghetti? Let them enter the pitch.
Uh-huh.
When he sweeps him, one touch, you understand that there is a difference between having flesh and having lean muscle.
Mm-hmm.
Capacity gives you spiritual lean muscle. If you understand physics, the physique of a man, you know that lean muscle is different from fat muscle.
That's true, sir.
Brother Charles.
Father.
This one is fat muscle.
Jesus.
Brother Charles. Sister Elsie, please, what are you feeding your husband?
Uh-huh.
I think mama needs to give me that delicacy.
Hey.
So you, after you cook for him, he will still go and cook for himself.
Uh-uh.
You like food.
Hey, it is working.
Is it working?
He's working.
He trains serious regime. They are on diet. If you ask him, he has his diet. You know, I have maintained one weight for 6 years. I have maintained this weight for 6 years. I don't go past 68 kg. I am not less than 68 kg. If I climb stone now, 68 kg, bam, whether I fast or I eat, 68 kg. There is no space for meat anymore. We have eaten diet. We are now the working diet.
Wow.
Many of you, you are wasting destiny by wasting your time to prepare. You are gallivanting with people who have prepared and are earning the profit of their preparation when you have not prepared yourself at all. Am I communicating here?
You're speaking,
you
sir.
Are jumping like frog. Back, back, back everywhere. Brock, brock, brock. You are jumping everywhere with people who have prepared, labored, and they're now in their season of enjoyment. Whereas for yourself, you've not put anything on ground. Ecclesiastes chapter 3. There is a time and a purpose. Your time to build capacity. Don't waste it on vanity. The time to build capacity. Don't waste it on vanity. Remember that everybody's race is different. Life is turned by turn.
Yes, sir.
The failure to prepare is so predominant inside church, but we want God to show up with a miracle. The miracle will kill you if you don't have capacity. Microwave miracle will fast track you into a pit. We people inside church, I'm not talking about outside, believers, we have a microwave mentality. The Lord said, tell my people to prepare. Preparation is pivotal. Write this down quickly so we can pray. I want to reemphasize this. Preparation is key to success. If you fail to prepare, you prepare to fail. Number two, preparation is key to manifestation. If you fail to prepare, you will not manifest. Because when opportunity comes but once. It is your preparation that puts you in the right position to change your situation. And you get to your desired destination. Preparation, number one, I said, is key to success. Number two, preparation is key to manifestation. Number three, preparation is key to destiny preservation. Preparation preserves destiny. It minimizes waste. And that brings me to number four. Number four, preparation minimizes the possibility of waste. Preparation minimizes the possibility of waste. Preparation minimizes the possibility of waste. And number five, preparation destroys anxiety and it extinguishes panic. Preparation, it destroys, it eliminates anxiety and it extinguishes panic. If you are still in panic, it's because you didn't prepare. I'm not saying that you won't go through situations even when you're fully prepared that might make you want to panic. It will shake you. But despite the shaking, a man well prepared regain his balance. That's where capacity kicks in. Look at a Range Rover. Or look at these big SUVs, the Toyota Land Cruisers. They've been prepared from the manufacturer's warehouse to go through the roughest of road. So when they get into a rough road, you see the bounce, that's the bounce, not the bounce, those big SUVs, they shake, they bounce. But in the bouncing, because of the capacity through preparation, they find balance. Child of God, if you are bouncing and falling, you're lacking capacity. If you lack capacity, you fail to prepare. If you faint in the day of adversity, your strength is weak. It means you've not been to the gym of prayers. Prayer is a gym.
That's right, sir.
Prayer is a gym. Oh. How about that? Prayer is a gym. When you see some people speak some tongues, Don't think that this you don't buy speaking in tongues from Sainsbury's. The more you spend time in the gym of prayer, your tongue gets thick, and the thicker your tongue, the devil fear you. Many of you are using kindergarten tongue to fight a university-sized devil.
Oh, my father.
I'm losing you.
At all, sir.
Pastor Brennan, love. You are using kindergarten, nursery school tongues to fight a tertiary devil. You better respect yourself and fight the small one that understand ha, ga, ga, go, go, go. Oh, yes. Ha, ga, ga. Do you think when a professor is talking and a nursery school student is talking, there's a level of knowledge. Even the way the professor comes in. So I'm here to tell you, the way they speak, their body's moving words. Are you understanding me? Stop using kindergarten tongues, gaga gugu, to fight a tertiary-sized devil. Look at what is happening in St. Vincent today. When I sent them a word, they were taking me like I'm a fool. The prophets they've known in the past, those ones, they are kindergarten prophets. They are still gaga, go, go, go. We will speak Yapu. We have gone past tertiary. We are entry professor.
Hey.
But yet we are still keeping it cool. Because why? We don't see ourselves as anything. The Bible says our sufficiencies of God. Not that we see ourselves as anything, but we've just made God to be our sufficiency. The Bible says, for the Lord shall be thy confidence. He shall not suffer thy foot to be taken. We've just chosen to let God be our confidence in ministry. Prophecy is what we were born from ear to toe to do. We don't guess to see. We see to define destinies. You think this is gaga, goo, goo, goo? Agugo gaga. Many of you have seen a tertiary devil. Agugo gaga. A gaga, goo, goo. A prime minister of a country in St. Vincent was boasting how a pastor that spoke against him, he wasted the pastor. I said, hey, I will waste you too. The pastor that he wasted in their coven, that one is a gaga, goo, goo. I'm not gaga gugu. We just throw past coven, meaning we've walked past coven, we have eaten coven food, we didn't die.
Hey!
We've seen coven. I have walked past one day, I saw they did sacrifice on the floor. They put boiled egg, palm oil, fish, Coca-Cola, it was like 600 naira inside plates on the floor, calabash. They said it was from a devil. Which devil? I was hungry. I picked the money, went to buy Coca-Cola and I ate bread and ate. I drank Coca-Cola and ate bread. Mm-mm. I am a deity myself.
Hey, hashtag AJE.
Shango sees me and brings offering. I don't think I'm...
Hey!
The witches in your village sees me and they bring tight.
Hey!
Hey! You understanding me? Do you know who I am? I am a royal priesthood.
Hey!
I am a holy nation.
Hey!
A peculiar person.
Hey.
I am not normal.
I'm not normal. Hey! Hey! Kingdom dynamite.
If you want to be ordinary, stay normal. It is only abnormal men that make it alive.
That's right, sir.
You think I'm joking?
At all.
When Mr. Bean was acting normally, nobody knew him. When he started acting like Mumu, he became a celebrity. If you want to be great, you better become abnormal. When I was prophesying and doing this prophecy, cool, nothing was happening. When I decided to start dealing with the devil abnormally, suddenly, boom. Boom!
Hey!
Not pa! Boom!
Dynamite!
Not a pa! Boom! May you blow!
Amen!
I say whatever God has put in you, you will blow!
Amen!
Whatever God has planned for you, you will arrive where?
Amen!
Wherever God wants you to get, you will get there!
Amen!
Lift your voice, shout, I am not normal!
I am not normal! Hey!
Listen, you cannot fulfill an abnormal destiny preparing normally.
That's right, sir.
Listen. Remain standing, we are going to pray. I'll repeat that and we'll pray. You cannot fulfill an abnormal destiny by preparing normally.
That's right, sir.
Let me break it down to you. Goliath was not a normal man. Amongst it, he took how many men to carry Goliath's sword? How many men? How many men did it take to carry Goliath's sword? Goliath's sword is ammo. How many? Sorry? Four men, you sure?
No.
Where are the Bible scholars? How many men did it take to carry Goliath's sword to battle? Every time Goliath is going to battle, the Bible says, and it took a certain amount of men to carry his armor. How many of them? Sorry? 12. No, wasn't 12. How many men did it take to carry Goliath's sword? How many? Six? You sure? How many men? How many? Okay, that is your weekly Bible study. Whoever finds it, I'll give the person Chinese tonight. Maybe to inspire and ginger your medulla oblongata. How many men? See, Sister Wendy is trying to open it. She's trying to find. Now, hear me before I can pray. That is your studies. I won't say that one. You say that one yourself. You go and study yourself. But whoever can find it quickly. Six. Please don't even try that. Now, hear this. Hear this. Goliath was not normal. He was a giant amongst men. The Bible called Goliath, what is it? Champion of the camp of the Philistines. A man born from Gath. Gath is their root descendant, part of the place of the children of Anak. The Anakims were giants. So for God to raise a David to bring down Goliath is training her to be abnormal. David spent many of his weeks, his days, his months in the wilderness tending to sheep and dealing with ravens, ravacious animals, bears and lions and wild unnegotiating beasts. I'm sure if it were some of you, you would have complained. Why is God taking me through the wilderness when my mates are in class? Why is God taking me through the wilderness when my mates are building career? You don't understand that your wilderness is what will produce your betterness. Your wilderness is what will preserve your life from wildering. David was trained abnormally to pull down an abnormal enemy. We are going to pray. Listen to me. Now watch this. In the place of abnormal training, David became abnormally built for battle. Hence the reason when he confronted Goliath, Goliath laughed in Samuel 17. He says, "Are you coming to fight me with stones?" Meaning David was not normal. If you are still using a predictable weapon against your enemy, the enemy will predictably defeat you. Are you understanding me?
Yes, sir.
The enemy will predictably defeat you. Preparation for successful living also comes from the place of abnormal training. Listen, I want to give you a revelation. So when you pray these two prayer points, you pray with anger. When David confronted Saul, watch this. The Bible says that Saul called David. He said, "Take my sword, take my armor, take my helmet." David actually put it on. But I love what David said. David said, "These things, they are too heavy for me. They are not comfortable for me." Many of you are using your friend's formula to fight your life battle.
Hey.
You are doing copycat. Life is not copycat. Life is original.
Yes,
everyone
sir.
Will be certified by the way they run themselves. My formula will not work for you
at all.
How about that?
Yes, sir.
Life is not copycat. Don't live your life doing see and do, see and do. Everybody jump one. You two, you jump. Today you are a builder. Tomorrow, nurse. Next tomorrow, doctor. Upper tomorrow, lawyer. Oh, next one, you are now working in the chamber of law. Another one, you are architect. Now you are now a pilot. Now you want to become a dentist, please. Not my teeth. Before you pull out something and make me go. Listen to me. You know what we never ask ourselves? If Saul's armor was that good for battle, why didn't he wear it himself to go fight Goliath? David would have died cheaply using Saul's tactics. God will give you your own tactics that shapes up your technique to bring down your enemy. Is your medulla oblongata busting?
Oh, yes.
Are you understanding me?
Yes, sir.
We're going to pray. David saw Goliath. Goliath said, "You are bringing stone." If Goliath knew that David has prepared, he has spent time knowing how many times he had to roll his sling and how to release it in a particular way to release the right speed, and that stone moving with a certain type of precision and speed, that came from the place of training, unusual, abnormal training. The way David used his sling to knock down Goliath is different from how you use a sling to kill a chicken. Your wilderness is your place of abnormal training to pull down an abnormal enemy so you can fulfill your abnormal destiny. If your destiny is still normal, it means it's not different from what everyone else is doing. That is why God-given destiny is always ridiculed at the start. Because men will not understand it until it starts blossoming and say, oh, wow. You are going to open your mouth in prayer. Father, the grace to prepare. The grace to be well prepared. The discipline to be well prepared. Father, let it come alive in me. Amen. Lift your right. I want prayer warriors here. You can't fulfill abnormal destiny praying normally. You can't fulfill great destiny putting hand in pocket and you are doing like this. We are not fighting a chewing gum devil. I want warriors here. Someone lift your voice of power and holler, my father. Someone say, my father, my father.
My father, my father.
As I begin to pray.
Oh Lord.
Someone say, oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
The discipline. And the grace. The velocity.
The momentum.
To be well prepared. To fulfill destiny. To live a successful life. Father. Activate it in me. Open your mouth and fire prayer.
Hey, Shabbat. Activate it in me. The discipline to be well prepared.
The discipline to be well prepared. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Second prayer point. The Bible says in Psalm 18 verse 34, He teacheth my hands to war, so that a bow of steel is broken by my hands. The Bible says in Psalm 35 of Psalm 18, Thou hast also given me the shield of thy salvation, and thy right hand has holding me up, and thy gentleness hath made me great. Verse 36 says, Thou hast enlarged, you have enlarged my steps under me, that my feet did not slip. But look at the first verse, 34. It says, He teacheth my hands to war. Father, may all the training you have given me in life not amount to waste. May all the training you have taken me through life, the test of life, the process of life, life's process itself, may it not amount to waste. Let me tell you something. You know that young man that the Lord ministered to just then? There was a time, even I was homeless as a young man in this country. I was carrying Morrison's nylon bag from house to house. God was teaching my hands for ministry. Carrying Morrison's nylon bag from Thames Smith to Abbey Wood. Anywhere Bele face I sleep. I know what it means. As a young man and as a married man, I've tasted it too. It's not fun. It's not good. It's a thing where you sometimes you want to give up. Imagine me wasting those days of training. I won't be here today. Ministry is backed not by grace, prayer, and fasting alone. It's also backed by what you have to say. He teacheth my hand for war. When God teach your hands for war, if God teach you personally, you will be a raw commodity. You will be raw and you are rare. Men can mentor you, but if God don't nurture you, your future will rupture.
Child.
Men can mentor you, but it is God that mentors you and you stand tall above men.
Come on, sir.
We are going to pray. May the teachings of life that, Lord, you have loaded in me, may it not go to waste. Lift your hands up and fight. My Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
Open your mouth and shout, my Father, my Father.
My Father, my Father.
As I begin to pray.
As I begin to pray.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
May all the teachings.
May all the teachings.
You have given me.
You have given me.
May it not go to waste.
May it not go to
may
waste.
May I not waste.
May I not waste.
The virtue of God in
the
me.
The virtue of
the
God in me.
The teachings of God in
the
me.
The teachings of
the
God.
The
impartation.
The word of God.
The word of God.
The nurturing.
The nurturing.
May it not waste.
May it not
may
waste.
It not waste.
May it not
may
waste.
I be ready.
May I be ready.
May I be ready.
May I be ready.
For the day of war.
For the day of
for
war.
The day of battle.
The day of battle.
Lift your voice up. Open your mouth and begin to fire
break.
May it not go to waste. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And our last prayer point, I said life is not copycat.
Yes, sir.
I want you to grab your neighbor's ear you are isolating with and shout inside. Tell your neighbor, maintain your lane.
Maintain your lane.
Grab the ear. Grab the ear. Grab it. Grab it.
Maintain
grab it.
Maintain your lane.
Grab the ear. Tell your neighbor, maintain your lane.
Maintain your lane.
Say, maintain your lane.
Maintain your lane.
Keep your eyes on the prize.
Keep your eyes on the prize.
Keep Keep your eyes
on the prize
as you run
the race
of life.
Keep your eyes
on the prize
as you run
the race of life.
Take your eyes
off someone else's rice.
If you eat that rice,
your stomach will turn to ice.
Your stomach. Hey!
Stop looking at someone's. Listen, the Bible says in Psalm 23, thou prepares a table before. It didn't say before us. Take your eyes off my table.
Hey!
Take your eyes off his table.
Uh-huh.
How long have you been playing keyboard now? Many years. The way he said, when I asked him, how long has he been playing keyboard? He said, man, he said, meaning, if you know, when he's doing, it's not today, he started doing do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do.
At all.
Mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, ti, re, I started many years ago.
Right, sir.
Take your eyes off my prize. Take your eyes off my rice. If you eat this rice cooked, your stomach will turn to ice. It won't take it away. See, no waters. Father in heaven, all these men in this ministry, your bellies are rising.
Hey, Jesus.
You are really eating well at home. I'm going to declare fasting for only men in this ministry. Except me.
And me, sir.
I don't want to fast, because if I fast, join this one, I will vanish.
Only for married men, sir.
I will disappear. Only for what?
Only for married men, sir.
Only for married men.
Yes, sir. They need to lose the weight, sir.
We'll start with Brad Charles and Senior Waters.
That's right, sir. And Dickie Nobina.
Listen. We're going to pray. Lift your right hand up. We're going to pray. Father, help me keep my eyes,
yes, sir,
on my lane. Hmm. There was something that happened recently in one of these Olympics just gone. How many of you know Michael Phelps?
That's right. Yes, sir.
Michael Phelps is the record holder of Olympics in swimming. Michael Phelps and about eight other competitors on the pool edge. They were ready to swim. On your marks. Get set. Bah! Meaning go. Everybody jumped into the pool. Michael Phelps was there. He will come out. Whilst Michael Phelps was maintaining his lane, all Michael Phelps was seeing is the gold medal. No matter the current of the water, he kept his eyes on the gold medal. The brother next to him kept his eyes on Michael Phelps. The guy will come out of water. He will look for Michael Phelps. Look for him. See, if you keep your eyes on how well others are doing, you won't do well in life.
That's right, sir.
If you keep your eyes on how well others are doing, you will measure your own success by their own success. Listen, because you are driving limo doesn't mean I will not own a limousine company.
Uh-huh.
Are you understanding me? Don't use someone else's success as a yardstick on how you will succeed, because their success might not match what God has got in stock for your future. Are you understanding me?
That's right.
This goat was there looking at another goat, but he didn't understand that there are two types of goats. There is a goat that is an animal, and there is a goat called greatest of all time. Listen, Michael Phelps was going, and he kept his eyes on the goal, because that goal carried his gold. But another man next to him went into the water and keeping his eyes on Michael Phelps. Listen, life may be hard. Your current might seem tougher than others. But ladies and gentlemen, swim. Tell your neighbor, swim.
Swim.
Keep your eyes on your lane.
Keep your eye on the...
Keep going.
Keep going.
Take your eyes off others. Because their speed might affect your own ability to get to destiny. You are going to pray. Lift your hands up. And you are going to, when I say fire prayer, you will now lay your hands on your head and you have to speak. One of the biggest mistakes that has killed people is that word. Look at how your mates are doing. Man of God, I need you to prophesy over my life. I say, why? Oh, man of God, my friends, look at how they're doing. My sister, look at how she's doing. That person, what is that about? That is why many have married wrongly, started different wrong careers because of how their friends are doing. You're going to pray, lift your two hands to the heaven, and you're going to open your mouth and you're going to shout, my Father, my Father,
my Father, my Father.
Someone say, Heavenly Father,
Heavenly Father.
As I begin to pray, give me grace and help me, oh Lord,
and help me, oh Lord,
to keep my eyes on my own lane, to keep my eyes on my own lane, as I run the race of life. Place your hands on your head, open your mouth, and begin to cry to
God.
Begin to pray.
Le proko zodosh, le gedevo zodododosh, le kebra kabalabadosh.
Begin to pray.
Le gedededededesh, zegedevo zodododosh.
Help me keep my eyes on my lane. Help me keep my eyes on my lane. As I run the rest of life. As I run my race in life. Help me keep my eyes on my lane. For you are glorious and worthy to be praised. You're the Lamb upon the throne, and unto you
and all to you. A voice in praise. You are the Lamb upon the throne.
For you say,
for you are glorious and worthy to be praised. You are the Lamb upon the throne.
My voice is praise.
You are the Lamb upon the throne.
We give you
all the glory.
We worship you, say.
We worship.
Everyone lift your hands and place on your head. Even those watching virtually on Apostolic TV, wherever you are connected by faith and by grace, just place your hands on your head. I want to pray tonight for everyone. But before I pray, I want you to understand that everyone's destiny is different. Your horn, see, no matter how many buffalo is in a herd, every buffalo have different size of horn. Your horn might be longer than mine. Doesn't make your destiny greater than mine. It's just me understanding my own destiny. Listen, I prophesy over the lives of everyone under the sound of my voice.
Yes, sir.
Whether you are watching physically or you are watching virtually, I decree, I declare over your lives.
Amen.
You will not fail.
Amen.
I don't think you heard me.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-sh.
I say you will not fail.
Amen.
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 I decree and I declare. As I speak now, let the hand of God himself begin to touch your head.
Amen.
Father, I pray that every head under the sound of my voice is not permitted to fail.
Amen.
You are not permitted to fail.
Amen.
You are not permitted to fail.
Amen.
The Bible says, thou art a shield to me, you are my glory and the lifter up of my head. I prophesy, the Lord shall become our glory.
Amen.
The Lord shall become your 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 glory.
Amen.
The Lord shall become the lifter up of your head.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Just lift your voice and begin to thank the Lord where you are. Just begin to thank the Lord for what you have received. Thank the Lord for what you have received. Blessing for what you have received.
Lord,
just thank him, thank him. You have 30 seconds to thank him.
To be
your thanksgiving friend determines how you live life on it. Determines your thank in life.
We give you, oh,
come on, thank him, thank him, thank him.
Oh, oh, oh,
your thanksgiving
glory
determines the level of your thank in life.
We worship you, Lord. You are worthy to be praised.
Father, we give you thanks and we bless your name. We celebrate you. Is there anybody here with contracts or proposal for, is it work or business? Lift them up above your head. Anybody with such? Lift them up above your head. Just lift up above your head. Just lift your hand above your head if you're one of those. I prophesy, I feel led to pray. Everyone watching Apostolic TV as well. Everyone trusting God for a contract or a proposal. Listen to me. I speak today. And between now and 12 midnight Wednesday, I stand on this altar of power, backed by grace, unctioned, ordained by God to be his oracle. And I prophesy that between this moment, this hour, and 12 midnight Wednesday, that contract would have been approved.
Amen.
I said that contract would have been approved.
Amen.
I said that contract would have been approved.
Amen.
I said that contract would have been approved.
Amen.
I said that contract would have been approved.
Amen.
That expectation would have been released.
Amen.
Everyone under the sound of my voice, I want to use as a point of contact, Christian. The Lord said you need a new job. You need a new job. You are looking for a new job. Lift your right hand up. Everyone trusting God for a new job, lift your right hand up. Or you want, if you have a job, you want promotion, you want increase in salary. I prophesy that this week is the week of that promotion.
Amen.
Is the week of that increase.
Amen.
Is the week of that promotion.
Amen.
Is the week of that increase.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sister Rubiza, you are moving home. I see people moving home. There is a sudden charge coming to your household, and it will cause you people to relocate. This one will come with is a better package, a bigger house. Write it down, 5-bedroom house. It's going to happen. It's coming without expectation. Look, you are, catch the moment you are writing. She's writing the prophecy. Everyone trusting God, listen. I am speaking with a charge to speak.
Hey.
That this week is a week of home settlement for all of us.
Amen. Kadosh.
It's a week of house settlement.
Amen.
Those who are trusting God for accommodation, this week will not pass you by.
Amen.
Listen, there are men that controls nature.
Yes, sir.
The Bible says Joshua was fighting, and their son stood still.
Yes, sir.
Till Joshua slayed his enemy.
Yes, sir.
It's Joshua, right?
Yes.
Was it Joshua? You sure?
Yes.
Eh? It's Joshua.
Yes, sir.
Lift your right hand up. I speak to the four elements of nature.
Hey. Sha-da-da-da-dash.
The four elements of nature is controlled by the cherubs. The cherubs are these celestial beings that sit on the mercy seat in heaven. The cherubs are designed with four faces: front face, side, left and right face, with a back face. Each face controls an element of nature: water, air, earth, and fire. I prophesy, backed as one, who the cherubs fight for his ministry. And I speak to the element of nature.
Yes, sir.
That this week, the air will work for you.
Amen.
I don't think you see. I have preached about preparation. I don't know how prepared you are to receive.
Hey.
I speak to the air. This week, the air will work for us.
Amen.
I speak to this ground.
Kabosh.
I put my feet on this ground as a prophet.
Yes, sir.
Because my feet is on this altar. Wherever our feet will touch this week, I prophesy that the ground will respond for your favor.
Amen.
The earth shall respond for our favor.
Amen.
In goodness, goodness will follow you.
Amen.
In mercy, mercy will follow you.
Amen.
In favor, you shall be favored.
Amen.
In favor, you shall be favored.
Amen.
In lifting, you shall be lifted.
Amen.
In harvest, you will carry them bountifully.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I speak to the water.
Hey.
Listen and hear me clear.
Kadabo.
There are those that devils speak to and they fear. There are those that put devils in their place.
Hey.
The Bible says in Job 38 verse 12, have you commanded thy money since thy days? Have you told, have you charged, have you instructed the day spring to know his place?
Yes, sir.
Listen, I am desiring some groundbreaking testimonies.
Hey.
So by that desire and that desire connected to the anointing.
Yes, sir.
I prophesy over my over your
prophesy.
Life. I prophesy over our lives.
Yes, sir.
Over the airwaves.
Yes, sir.
And I speak that as many that drink water.
Hey.
Your helper, as long as your helper, your lifter, those that God have designed to change your life, as long as they have water in their system, anything living that has water in its system, Amasha, may that water in their system begin to lead them to favor you.
Amen.
If they don't obey, the water will begin to make them uncomfortable.
Amen.
Let that water in them begin to propel them to locate you for your prosperity.
Amen.
Begin to propel them to locate us for our prosperity.
Amen.
Locate us for prosperity.
Amen.
Locate us for turnaround.
Amen.
Turnaround.
Amen.
Turnaround.
Amen.
Turnaround.
Amen.
Turnaround.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And I speak to the fire.
Hey, shock.
That this week, please hear me, especially those in the Caribbean islands. Listen. The same fire that kills some people is the same fire that some people used to cook.
Hey.
When you have stove, you use stove to cook, right? Do you know that there is no volcano that can burn God? Volcano is the same stove God used to cook. It's like a pot. Volcano is like a pot. Listen. Whatever will consume others this week, I prophesy.
Prophesy.
That same place shall be the place you resume your joy.
Amen.
I don't know. Am I talking to someone here?
Yes, sir. Yes,
whatever
sir.
Whatever the devil have designed to consume others,
Kadush,
the fire, the propelling intensity of fire,
hey,
that has been designed to consume others.
Yes, sir.
I prophesy.
Prophesy.
That same fire shall prepare a beautiful meal for you.
Amen.
That same fire shall prepare beautiful meal for us.
Amen.
We shall be served well.
Amen.
We shall be served well.
Amen.
We shall be served well.
Amen.
With good meal from the kitchen of Jehovah.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And so shall it be.